Side is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. Buy genuine Soundman iPad dash kits at soundman.co and find high-quality car audio equipment at nvx.com. We are also sponsored by U.S. Alternators, Down for Sound Shop, and Audio Control. Well, do we have a heck of a show for you. Wait till you see what happened. Oh no, look what happened. All right, today the goal is to figure out where we're putting the baffle board. EXO was putting his baffle board in, I saw on his YouTube thumbnail. People are like, oh, you better hurry. He hasn't even started his door panels yet. Welcome back, everybody. I hope you're having a good turd this morning. We missed a few videos on you, huh? Okay, come on over here, camera boy. Camera boy is here. We're looking at about 60 and a half, roughly. Okay, now I'll tell you how to find the center line of something when it's rough. Okay, we got 60 and a half. What's half of that? 30 and a quarter. Yes, you're doing good math while you're shitting. Do your math while we're shitting. Okay, come on over. Don't get away from me now, camera boy. Okay, so if that's 30 and a quarter, look what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna hit this tape measure. I'm gonna put it right there. Bam, 30 and a quarter. Right here, look. Look where it landed. Right on the seam of the wood. I must have already figured the center and landed it right on the money. That's something I would do. Okay, and if it's not perfect right on the money, you just go from the other side like this. Look, 30 and a quarter. Let's see where this one lands. See right here. So the center is actually, in actuality, between these two lines, you see? You see that? Did you learn something? I hope you did. Okay, that way if you don't get an accurate measurement, you go both ways and you get a center. Do you get it? Do you get it? Leave a comment if you get it. Okay, come on over here. Look. Look. Look at this, huh? Ooh. Look at that. There used to be a dent, remember? Remember the paint and bodywork podcast party we were trying to do and then the camera boy wasted all our time with his vehicle. Oh, the subframe is complete. The subframe is done. Roll the clip of the subframe. Roll the clip now. Go on. Go on and roll it. Okay, now we gotta find the center of this. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, okay. Subframe project is done, boys. We took it to Big John's for an alignment. He charged me an astronomical fee. I thought he was supposed to be my friend. He wants me to advertise for his shop, and he's gonna charge me double. Come on, Rob. Rob is my buddy from high school. Now he's gonna see that. He's gonna go, oh, Doug, you ruined my business. Oh no, what did you do? Big John is so mad. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do is get this tape measure here. We're gonna go from pillar, between the pillar, but from between the pillar to the pillar. So camera boy got himself a real job. A high-paying career opportunity as a Chippendales dancer. He's working at a health and fitness center, and I'm trying to fit the subwoofers in this, and he's talking about fitness. Oh, hey, camera, put that, camera boy, get that in there. Get it in there and hold it there. Okay, now good. Okay, no, what, did the gimbal go wonky? No.
The wire got snagged on the
Come on, camera boy. Everyone's gonna miss.
It's got me doing this shit that ain't my ability.
Everyone's gonna miss the camera boy antics. It's right on the metal, right? So we're gonna go. Okay, I'm trying to get an accurate measurement here because we're laying the baffle board in. 63, and that's gonna be right at 64. Okay, who's shitting on the shitter doing math? What is it? Half of 64. I didn't say let it go, camera boy. 32. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. 32, give me a poo. Ooh, 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 give me a poo. 32, give me a zoo. Okay, look, 32. Okay, well, this needs to be accurate. That's why I'm kind of trying to do it right. I'm taking my time, my sweet ass time. I can't have no crooked ass baffle board in there like EXO put his in. I saw it was sitting in there crooked. Go watch the video. Go say sound man sent me. And then if you see it, leave your own opinion of his crooked baffle board. Don't say what I told you to say. Okay, you see for yourself. I'm not trying to tell people what to... Go ahead and get his dumb views up. I don't give a shit. My views already went to hell with this dumb bullshit idea you had.
It's you.
Fucking Tim Cook said you could make a movie with an iPhone. And I bought it, and now look, my views went down. I'm so fucking pissed about it. So what I'm thinking is we can go back to the old style videos and everyone can yuck it up.
Yuck it, I like the fucking stupid jokes.
I could fucking come up with more fucking wheat, loaves of wheat bread. Really hungry. I could go for a hog on wheat right about now. A hog on wheat sandwich. I mean, my hog on your wheat bread. Okay, listen. But when Camera Boy breaks his car, we can also do these videos. We could do subframe videos and... No, we should do the regular videos and then do these once in a while. So everyone could get a good, nice hour-long shit out. Hey, get in on what I'm doing here. Okay, do you see what I did there? Get in close on that. We measured the width. The width. The width of her. And then we subtracted the half by divided by. And then we measured from this side and that side. We put a screw right between the dots. That's the perfect center. We can't measure off the side walls because the side walls are different. Because if you didn't notice, there's a door on this side. Come notice the door. I body worked it while you're gone. Just kidding. I didn't do shit to this one. I went and bought a $90 piece of wood. I can't finish the base van at these prices. Someone's gonna have to steal me some birch. Son of a fucking birch. So what I'm gonna do with that one board is we're gonna get the placement exact. Exact placement of the baffle. And then what we're gonna do with that board is get it the right size it needs to be. Test fit it on both sides. So it's a symmetrical board. Then we have to figure out how this back area is gonna be. These chambers, it's gonna be a sealed chamber on this side, sealed chamber on this side. The back needs to be blocked off. And there's gonna be amps and batteries. So this is gonna come out at a 45 because we have a window on this side. So we need a 40, this is gonna come out at a corner. And we're gonna go about a foot off the wall because we're looking at a sealed 15. So if we have 12 inches here, we'll have 12 inches by 15 by 15. What is that? Do the math. A cube and a cube and a quarter per woofer. We wanna nail the sealed dimensions. So from my experience, I'm guessing about a foot off of the wall. So maybe we'll go right about here. And then the middle chamber is going to be a ported chamber. What if the cubic footage isn't right? Shit. That's what we're going to need to find out. And then now in these corners, I'm going to point over here with my tape measure. Go ahead and zoom in on over here in this corner over here. Camera boy, get in on that over there. See this? See this corner here? This needs to come out on at 45 because of the seats. You see? What do you want, a fucking board hitting the side of your head? And we have a window here. You see all this right here? Zoom in right here. Real close. Get in real close on the camera boy. You can do it. See? That's all filled with PL Max, baby. Look at that. Yeah, baby. That's called the PL wedge technique. Okay, now, get serious. Okay, this isn't some kind of joke. You think we're building this for some kind of joke? When I'm done with this, I'm gonna ship it to Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, and say, here's your van. We're gonna put a mural of his face on the side. And it's gonna say, the car audio fab kitchen. And he's gonna be going, $10,000 mural. That's what kind of joke I think this is. Fucking dumbass idiot. Never made anything that bumped. Show you how to master car audio. Okay, so let's get... Come on, guys, you're jaw-jacking. Do you know what this is? What are we, 40 minutes in? We haven't done shit. That's why these videos ain't working. You ain't getting dick done. Hold this up, camera boy! The van was supposed to be painted by now. I should make camera boy paint the van, dude. Get to sanded, camera boy!
You must be tripping.
I work at a professional fitness center now. I can't do it. Okay, did you get the line I snapped? You missed it, dude. You missed the fucking good part, dude. Zoom in on that line, boy.
You see it? Little crayon line.
See that crayon line? Damn, it looks good in that high definition 4K camera. You could film a movie with that. Final Butt Pro on a MacBook Slow is the worst piece of shit situation. Toy computers is what we're dealing with here in 2020. Back in my day in the 90s, we had real spinning hard drives. I'm talking about Windows 95.
And floppy disks, discs.
Floppy disks, where you could really get some work done. Okay, come on. I could edit a movie faster with a floppy disk than with this Apple crap. Dude, what if I sit on this screw, dude? Because I need to sit right here? That's why I might. What if I was jaw-jacking, not paying attention? Okay, look, I'm going to go off of here and go to here. That's probably centered. That's looking at 39 and a quarter. So what is that? What's 39 and a quarter? 19 and an eighth? No. 19 and a half plus an eighth. 19 and a half plus 1/8. It's gonna be 5/8. Just 4/8 plus 5/8. Huh? 19 and 5/8. Okay. Let's take a look at this. This is already marked right here.
19 and 5/8.
Somebody already came in here and did it. Oh, look at that. They did both marks for me. My past self must have came up in here and did that. Good looking out, past self. I could really go for some... Oh, no, I screwed through the roof. I could go for some Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure right about now. 205. Alan Rahim from NVX Audio. Let's see what he has to say. Maybe it's something about... He's going to get me woofer sealed specifications tomorrow. He's probably taking a shit right now. Way to go, Alan. See? Wait till you see this van when it's done, I'm telling you. In 3 years, this is really going to be bumping. All right. This looks like I marked the center. Once upon a time. 80, 53. What is it, camera boy? What's half of 53?
51, or...
26 and a half? Too slow.
Something like that. Sure.
He did it. Hope you don't need math at your new job.
Not really.
Camera boy's gonna miss this job.
Who told you that?
He said it was his favorite job he ever had. To come in here every day and get yelled at about his subframe. You really screwed that one up, camera boy. Screwed up your subframe, didn't you?
Sure. You know what I crashed was right after filming?
Hey, so you're trying to blame it on me? Yeah, now he's trying to blame it on me. Because he was filming when he crashed.
Blocked.
No, you were out goofing around. Listening to Initial D music. Driving like it's Fast and the Furious front wheel drift.
It's all your fault.
Dude, they may need to make a Fast and the Furious front wheel drive edition. Fast and the Furious 14 front wheel.
It'll just be all crashes.
Front wheel city. Yeah, it could be kids understeering into the curb. One after the damn other. Jeez. One damn kid after the damn other. Look at that, camera boy. We're gonna double measure this. 26 and a half. So my first vehicle, my dad let me drive this Dodge van. It was the old base van. It used to be the base van when I was a kid, and then when I got older, he took everything out of it and just made it a wood getter. It was a little wood getting Dodge minivan, dude. So that was the first car I drove. And me and my buddies were, I was squirreling around in a parking lot. And my buddy Jake was in the back. And I was like whipping turns and he was like flopping around in the back. Dude, I went up this curb so hard, dude. He like launched up and hit the ceiling. That's my story of blowing a rim out. Fucking caved the rim in. I had to call my dad.
Dad. My wheel blew out for no reason.
I was just sitting there doing nothing. And the rim blew out. All right. Come on, everyone, leave your story of when you crashed your first... When you slammed your car into a curb. Oh, no, it's not going to reach. Look.
Yeah, look.
Oh, it did. It did reach. You got to really give it a guitar snap.
Oh, look at that. Make it a...
No, I know. Well, the first one went crooked, stupid. We don't need your commentary, camera boy. We're gonna give it a multiple snap. Look at that. It's this one. Way to put two lines on there, camera boy.
Told you, dude.
Okay, look. I'm gonna wind up my wire. All right. That's the center of her. Okay, now the next dilemma is that this curves this way. Because I didn't make mine flat like EXO did. I didn't do flat panels with expanding foam above it that are going to crack out in the heat. And the base is going to rattle them around. So not only is his roof dented, he's got broken up expanding foam under there. It's going to take away bass. All the movement is going to take away decibels. Okay, we thought about that. We took that into account. Curved all surfaces. This way, this way, this is basically a dome. This is a dome unit. Okay, now I'm not gonna hit my head on the screw and carve a chunk of my hair out, scalp myself for your entertainment. Even though you would really love it. Remember that time I dropped a board on my head? Make board. Next on my list is to make the board. Okay, we're gonna get this piece of paper. I'm gonna get a tape measure. Where'd it go? It's gone. Tape measure's gone. Where'd you put it? Camera boy stole it. What are we in? Oh no, 20? That's it? I thought we were 3 hours in. Whew, I'm sweating. We could probably roll the ads. Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high-output alternator from U.S. Alternators. Visit usalternators.com. Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Audio Control has what you need to make your good stereo system sound better. Take a look at Audio Control's full line of equalizers, line drivers, digital signal processors, and more at audiocontrol.com. I can get down with that. Okay, see, here's what we're gonna do. Look, now if we have the center line here, you little jerk. I'm talking to you, camera boy. Come on. We can go 12 inches from the center line. Bam. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Where's this gonna give me from here? Let's see how. 19. 19. Okay, so if we do a foot away from the wall, and a foot away from the center line, what is that gonna give us, camera boy? It's gonna give us a 2-to-1 ratio, fourth order bandpass clamshell. Okay? Do you get it?
What's the clamshell?
Don't talk about clams. Okay, so this is good because now if I go 12 inches from the center line, that's gonna give me 24 inches. Of girth. And then with this 24 inches of girth, I have 19 inches here. So what I want to do is a 3-board thick baffle board, which is going to be 2 and a quarter, 1, 2 and a quarter. So that's still going to give me 16 inches from the baffle board to here. Our goal is to stay 12 inches. But we have this upper area to worry about. So we need to, once we kind of get this set in, or figure out where we want it, which I think is gonna be right here. See, this is where it's gonna get tight, is on the top. So 12. 2 and a quarter. So if the baffle board's that thick and ends there, 12, dude, right on the money. So at the smallest part, we'll have 12. So that should give us, what's 15 times 15 times 12 divided by 17, 28? Give me that math. Oh, I have, camera boy has my phone. This stupid ass filming with an iPhone. 15 times 15 times 12 equals, divided by 17, 28. That gives us a cube and a half sealed per 15. And then we have some extra room on the bottom, and we also have woofer displacement. So we're going to have more than that. And then in the middle, we want to end up with double the airspace as the sealed. Oh, that's not going to work. That's not going to work. Here's why. Because this needs to be double per side. Per side needs to be double. It's not going to work. We have to start over. Cut the baseband in half. We need to do it differently. And how deep is this 15, hmm? How deep is it? Because we could go that we're just going to have to scoot these where they need to be. So this is going to have to be... We're going to move that in 4 inches if we can. You know how... I'm thinking these woofers probably take a pretty small sealed woofer displacement. Or sealed box. And I don't know about the woofer displacement, so.
So that's what we're going to do, kids.
So now I don't know where I want to put that. So what I'm going to try to do here is measure this. I need to know where I'm going to put it so I can measure this. Because our height is changing. Forty-four and a half. So here's going to be the problem. We're going to measure this in quadrants.
Measuring quadrant one.
Why don't you get in on the paper if you're going to stand there and yawn.
44 and a half. Okay, that's quadrant one, which is going to probably land right about here.
Okay, we're eyeballing her, baby. We're giving her eyeball. Oh, that's going to be 45 if we go there. Look.
Shit. Shit. Shit, howdy.
Okay, look. Let's do this differently. We're going to have to measure this because we have to snap another line. What about 15, hmm? Can we squeeze it?
Squeezer, squeezer.
15, baby.
Fifteen
off the center line, baby. So what we got to do, what I'm trying to do, it would be good to land with roughly twice the airspace in the middle chamber as the seal chambers combined. So whatever the volume is here and here, this needs to be twice as much. Then we'll be able to tune a port for it that fires out of the front, right into your face. I'm going to blast you so hard with bass in your face. Wait till you see it.
Hi, guys.
Are them turds slid? How them turds sliding?
Turd sliding, turd sliding.
Okay, and here's the idea. I need to get this baffle board done before I finish off the roof. Because this is going to come out here. The acrylic windows are going in. Then the one layer of baffle board is going in. Then the next roof panels are going in. Then that baffle board's getting sandwiched. Like a ham on hog. And then it's going to slide out like this. It's going to have a channel in the roof. For maximum structural base. EXO's baffle board's going to fall out. I'm just calling it now. Oh no, some guy's coming in here, a customer from the Acura dealer. Right over to here. Line it right up like this. Okay. Snapping baffle board line one. Ooh. Give it a double snap-a-rooney. All right. Try not to step on my old line. It's gonna disappear on me. I feel like a carpenter.
That weak snap. What a weak snap
job. Okay. See, now we're gonna fucking be running magnets into the wheel well. Woofer magnets. I dropped it. I need a mounting depth. What's a depth on her?
Measuring for base. Hey, you guys want to come over later and measure for base?
Don't look at the time. You're not having fun? You're not having fun here, camera boy. What time is it? You're late for work? Oh no, you're going to get fired. You're going to have to film every day.
Yep.
Why don't you just sit here, live in the base van, and film every day? Could you do that? You can do it. You can do it, camera boy. They all love you. Everyone say farewell to camera boy. Never gonna come back again. He's on to bigger and better things. All right, look at that, you little shit-licking hillbilly.
Well, shit-lick me a hillbilly. Oh!
Fucking stabbed my finger. We got a wobbler. Damn, dude. Bleeding. Oh, wait, that's marker.
Oh no.
Get your calculators out. Double check my math.
We're going in.
I mean, we're going to stuff 12s or some other size woofer in here. If the 15s ain't going to fit,
they'll fit. I think they'll fit.
All right, this is a balancing act. 15, bam, right here, bitch. Don't look at the fucking watch, camera boy.
I gotta be done in 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
I gotta go back home and get my clothes.
I'm dropping you off at work.
I gotta get my clothes.
Then you're walking? Where am I dropping you off, camera boy? Where am I dropping you? Home or work, baby? This ain't chauffeur business. Camera boy's car is working, but he doesn't have insurance. He didn't pay for his insurance, didn't go through. Here we go. Maybe one of the viewers works for Geico and they could hook you up on a steal of a deal. Look at that. What are we in, camera boy?
35.
We're only 35 minutes in. You're gonna make the last video short so you can go to your stupid job? Is that what you're trying to do?
Dumbass trying to get me to come over here at shitty times.
Goofing around, dude. Goofing around. Okay, let's see what we ended up with, you shit smellers. How's that shit smelling? 4K HD turd breaks, baby. It was a good summer. I slid a lot of turds. 12. How did that end up on 12 again still? 16. 15. Oh, it landed on 12 because 16. This is 11. Or 10 and 3 quarter. Okay, so that's perfect because we need a 3 quarter inch piece of acrylic here. So it's actually looking pretty swell. And then between the middle, we should have 30 between the middle. So what does that give you if you guys calculate the airspace real quick? Baffle board's going in. So we just need to know how deep they are. I'd like to fit 3 and 3 on each side. Is how many woofers is EXO putting in? 12? Trying to put the same amount of woofers. Watch, it's gonna bump twice as loud. I'm talking about his. What if it sounds like shit? Okay, so now here, I need to start measuring these quadrants between these lines here because we have a curve this way. So, you know what we should do? We should see, since we have this line here, how much space do we want to give us? Should probably put this at, let's keep it shallow in here. 12. 12 and 12. So this is going to be something like this. Don't itch your pecker, camera boy. I can see you. You're wiggling the camera around, waggling your pecker around. Okay, do you see what we're doing here, camera boy? Are you getting it?
No.
Are you understanding yet?
No.
Are you getting it? Okay, so that's gonna be the back wall shape. And then we gotta measure it from here. That's 45. 46. 46, 46 and a half. So that might just be an angle. So I'll do that same measurement here. Are we gonna even have room for fucking 3 woofers across? 45? Ooh. If we butt them up against each other, it's 45, but we have 57 inches of room. Damn, it's gonna be swell. What if we go 12 inches on here real quick too? Look. What time is it, camera boy?
2:30.
2:30, he's gonna get fired. 12, I don't have time to get my straight edge, because Camera Boy's gonna get fired, and now I'm gonna have to make the line crooked, which is gonna cause it to not bump as hard. All because of him and his dumb job. Way to go, Camera Boy. Congrats on your job, Camera Boy. Everyone say it. Send him some super chat money. I'll keep it. I'm gonna keep it. Camera Boy's going through school and working. Like a hard working young lad. Okay, look at that. So that's how much box room we have. This is gonna be port. This is gonna be angled wall, window. I'm gonna have to get that acrylic cut soon. It's gonna be expensive as all dick and balls and all hell. Shit, hell, damn, all hell to dick. Dick, damn, hell. How much is this? Oh. Okay, Camera Boy, we gotta hurry. 60 fucking inches, baby, of width. 60. Okay, so this is actually gonna, these corners are gonna gain us some airspace that we wouldn't normally have in the rectangular situation. So we could even move this wall back if our mounting depth allows. So what we're gonna have to do is start taking some calculations. I wanna put a board in, mark fucking where everything's gonna go. I wanna exact mark where all the boards are gonna be. And then, we can start calculating airspace, make sure this thing's gonna bump. Well, shit howdy. Okay, so it'll be a little bit. I'm gonna film, I'm gonna be working on stuff. We're gonna put out a banger Base Wars video. Base Wars 15, baby, or whatever we're on. Wait till you see it. It could be like a goddamn movie. I'll show Tim Cook how to make a movie with an iPhone. It's time to pinch it off. I'll see you next time. Purchase industry-leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high-quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.